this world, changing your mindset.
Information technology is one aspect that Nigerian people noticed earlier in life. My guest today is one man who went that lonely road. Welcome to another edition of your weekly TV talk show, Be This World. It's my pleasure to have you join us this week. A quick break, and I'll be right back. Don't get away. If you just joined us, this is Be This World. And my guest today on the show is one man who has given ICT face in Nigeria. A man who said that if we really need to develop in Africa, that our development lies on our brain. Join me to welcome on the show Dr. Bayero Agabi. It's my pleasure to have you on this Be This World.
Thank you for having me.
Wow.
That was a huge one.
It needs to be. Because do you know that the name is bigger than the owner? Bayero Agabi. I started hearing that name when I was in school.
Many have said so.
And look at you here. You know, I was expecting, you know, our mentality in Africa. Maybe I'm still a very fat and big
man. I can remember, I think I went to see one man, I think at a cool hotel. And then when he saw me, he said, I was expecting to see a man with convoy and policemen and all of those things. Well, that is just me, anyway.
That's simple, man.
Thank you very much.
Wow. So how did it start? Today in our society, we'll have issue our youth getting job. You hear unemployment in Africa. And today, so many youth have started some businesses. And you've seen some people, after 3-4 years, they go back, dust their CV, walking on the streets to look for employment.
Do you wish to meet your role model, mentor, or celebrity? Send your name and the name of the person you wish to meet to the number on the screen or to our email. Be This World, changing your mindset.
Tell us, how did it all start?
Okay, maybe I should start from the last. You know, a sustainability of business or of your enterprise, you know, is dependent on what you really want to achieve at the end of the day. A lot of people go into enterprise or entrepreneurship without, having a roadmap. But I can tell you, I also have attended the Lagos Business School, the EDC, that is the Enterprise Development Center. There's a research that up to 70% of those who start business, I mean the SMEs, they don't even have their business, properly put together, business plan properly put together. They just go in there with the mind that they have practiced journalism for a long time, or sometimes I was an engineer in one company and therefore I can do business. So when is it time for the business to evolve its own life cycle? Okay, that means the business, the money with which you started the business is now off. Now it's time for the business to take off its own life cycle. That is when you begin to have issues of paying staff, of taking care of your family, of running your life the way it used to be. You cannot give your children the kind of life they used to live. And before you know it, you go back into employment and all of that. So those are just the key issues. And then...
the life cycle of the business.
Yeah.
When does it actually start?
It starts when your first money goes down. You understand what I'm saying? Your seed must go off for the business to begin to earn money for itself.
And this is not earning money for itself.
If it's not earning money for itself,
it becomes a problem.
It becomes a problem. And what usually results from that, the reason for that also is lack of skill on the part of the leadership or the owners or those who run the business. Because we always assume that because we are the CEOs, because we run the business, we have all the ideas, we have all the know-how, we have all the push and the vision to move the business to the next level. But we never look at the business perspective from the perspective of the staff that we also run in that business. So anything that goes wrong, we always blame the staff. If anything goes the other way, we always blame the staff. So we don't look at what we also contribute
as a CEO
and all of those things. And so You have a business you run, you are not on salary, and anytime you need money, you just go and take the money, and you call the accountant, please, how much do you have there? And the accountant tells you, and you write the money, and you go away, and your staff are watching you. You know, it's a way of telling them that this is how I run my business. So the business is for me and my family. You are just here to contribute. You are just a wage earner. You are not earning salary. So that still resonates in their brain, and they work in that life.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll go back to where I started before we begin to talk about enterprise and the sustainability of enterprise. I started in channels. I wasn't even a university graduate.
Please, let's get through with this before we go down.
Okay.
So we don't miss anything.
Okay.
Now, you find out in this our society today, so many people start business out of passion.
Yes.
Probably I'm a dancer.
Yes.
I love dancing. Mm. Or probably I can act. Mm. And people are going to open my own business. Now, it's the business started out of passion. Now, monetizing it becomes a problem from what you said.
Yes.
When the life cycle starts.
Yes,
so
exactly.
How do they go from passion to monetizing the business?
I put it this way for you. I always tell people that if you're starting a business, you know, mentorship is in three ways. From books, from a distance, or from someone you are closely knit with. Okay. So look at your mentor. The person you want will be like in future, right? If you see a man who's successful in business, you have to do your business in the way that he did it. If, for instance, you want to become another kind of Dakote, you have to do your business in the way
Dakote
he did
does
it.
So,
you get what I'm saying? So what we usually do, we start our businesses based on passion, okay? And if you start your business based on passion, and without the requisite skill on how to run a business itself, which is a different line, you are likely to fail, or you remain there for too long and all that. You see, one small plant, and that business has been there for 20 years, you know, and the numbers are just nothing to go about. If you check their bottom line, it's just the same, you know. So they will tell you they went to a certain bank, that the bank doesn't want to give them money. Why should the bank give you money? When it is clear that you are not on salary, so how do you survive? So your family and everything, your friends, your anything survives from that business, and so it is not structured. What am I saying? Sustainability of business has to be clearly written out. The skill for you to be passionate about business, that means you've been in that business, for instance, maybe you've been an engineer in a particular company for like 10, 15 years, and now you want to start an engineering company. It does not take a good engineer to run an engineering company to success.
Sarah, did you hear that?
So it takes one who understands the skills of running a business to drive a business to success.
I like that.
So if you now want to run a business to make it profitable, you also have to go acquire the skills of how to run a business. So don't assume because you've been an engineer for 10, 15 years, and therefore you can run a business and it becomes successful.
Thank you. I like that. That's a big lesson we've learned today.
So there are skills that you have to learn. That is why we have business schools. So that Nigerians always avoid those skills. They always assume,
I can do it.
I always say it this way. I said, a nurse can never become a doctor unless so trained.
Yeah.
No matter how long
you
have been a nurse, you can never become a doctor unless so trained. If you are a mechanic on the roadside, you can never become an engineer unless so trained. So why do you think that because you are an engineer, you suddenly become a successful entrepreneur if you did not acquire the skills to run a business?
It's okay, that's good. So now let's start from where you started.
Yes.
In one of your interviews, you said that when you started the Infotech TV talk show, you were not a graduate.
Yes.
Please tell us, how did it start?
You know, it started from channels. I just had a diploma, you know, from University of Lagos in computer science. from the computer center in Unilag. Yeah. And then when I did my IT, so when Channels was to start, because John and I, we are first cousins, and so I had no other choice than to just say, we join, Channels is coming up. Mm-hmm. I said, what is Channels? He said, Channels is coming up. So from his father, from his father and everything.
He doesn't even know what
to say. So he said, yes. So check the, say you study computer, go check the computer, you see the number. So I saw everything, the proposals and everything. So he said, Channels is coming up. So everywhere he was going, I followed him. The letters to the board of directors and all of those things, I distributed those letters and all of that. So we started. And then the job I was doing was...
Are we talking about here?
1992, 1993.
Yeah.
I just left secondary school and then I just joined. And I just finished my diploma.
Yeah.
Okay. And then my job was using computers to create graphics, animations and all of that, and then later on editing and all that. So those are the things I usually was doing. Then I crossed over to AIT after some years, because we moved from Dolphin Estate to Etebet's place. We were from Etebet's place across to AIT. And then when I go to AIT, I saw the...
Why did you leave Channel for AIT? Your cousin's art fit. Why did you leave Channel
you
for AIT?
You are too probing. You are too... Anyway, there wasn't any problem. The issue was that, you know, when you work with your brother, who knows how you grew up, who knows how you sleep and wake up, there's always this thing of try to look down on the skills or the talent and giftings that you are given.
Yeah, you are being limited.
You are being limited. So there are times I will do a voice, and the producers will say, no, this voice is very good. And the guy will just walk down and into the studio, you say, whose voice is that? You say, it's Bayero. So, no. It's not good enough.
You wanted a place you will excel.
So, that continued for a very long time and all that, but I can tell you that those things that he put in me, you know, those were the things that really, 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 really helped me to excel, even when I was in AIT. So, when I crossed over to AIT, there was this infighting of... The time I came in and the letter that you get and all of that, kind of placement and all that, I didn't want to follow the time. There was sports. If you wanted to do sports, instantly everyone will know you're doing sports. Mm-hmm. Business was there. If you do politics, quickly you make money, or maybe if you interview one or two politicians, they will give you money and all of those things and all that. So I didn't want to go through that crowding and all of that. And so I said, okay, I have a diploma in computer science. Let me try to see if I can teach computer on air and all of that too, and let's see how it goes. And when I started, it was strange to so many people, even within the establishment where I worked, that was AIT and all that. But after a while, sometimes I even go to cover events, and they will tell me, no, we don't want you. I will say, oh God, please, it's free. Don't just let me enter. It's free. They will say, no, we don't want TV. We don't want TV. But I started doing it, we go through the back door, I would read newspapers, see the trend, global trend, I try to relate it to global trend. So I brought journalism to bear into computer science. So my success was not because of my knowledge in computer science, but my journalism knowledge helped to push, you know, the computer information to the various, you know, sectors, exactly.
Most time when you go to them, they reject you from getting access to them. But before you answer that question,
Hey, all eyes open. Everything's Bluefic right here on Biddy's World. My name is Kofi Dohun, a comedian, actor, singer, entrepreneur. I'm a nut case. Yes, I'm telling you, stay here. If you have any reason to move your TV with you, but you can't go nowhere. This is the show. It's Biddy's World. By the way, we need sponsor. We need you to partner with us and make it worthy, you know, for the next generation, for your generation, even the past generation.
Welcome back to Just Joining Us. And my guest today is Dr. Bayero Agabi. Now, Dr. to get the hero.
Yeah.
I like that name so much. It sounds big. Right? How were you able to manage this rejection? Because that's a lot of things a lot of youths are facing today.
Yes.
A lot of people cannot manage rejection. You are rejected several events, even when you're offering it for free.
Yes.
How are you able to manage those rejections?
I think it was just God, and then again, believing in yourself that you can do it. You have to, because I was the only TV person doing information technology on television. So it was strange to them. So I wasn't too surprised, I wasn't too shocked. But I believed in myself that what I was doing, what I was into, was the right thing. So what I was doing was buying magazines, buying newspapers, both foreign and local, to take a look at IT trends and then relate them to what is going to happen or what was not happening in Nigeria. And then I would just write my report. So I go to offices and they beg them to please up for interviews, and they grant me those interviews and all of that. I can tell you that within the first 1 quarter, I won the best reporter within the AIT newsroom.
Wow, Bayra Gabi, you are actually doing well. Yeah. I commend your efforts. Yeah. You're doing well. You're a woman who said that African development is in our brain.
Yes.
Why did you say that? And how are we going to achieve that?
Yes,
we still have a lot of youths who still say there is no job. Mm. And we still have about, 65% of our youths are still depending on their certificate.
See, that is the irony of our society today. A lot of people send me emails to say they are looking for jobs. I always will laugh. You know, we are in a knowledge environment. But see, the idea of tribe, where you come from, your color, your name, your femininity, or whatever, has been broken down by the knowledge environment. So, information technology has provided that. You know, has shrunk the skill gap, has also shrunk, the gap of I'm looking for job or I'm not looking for job and all of those things. What those guys should be telling me seriously is that how can I use information technology to grow the kind of skills that I have? Don't try to be a computer expert, but try to use information technology to grow the skills that you have.
Let's go for a quick break. More return, we'll continue. I guess still remain by your way. And then we'll find you. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Just Join Us. This is Baby's Blog. My guest today on the show is Dr. Bayero Agazi. So before we went on break, we talked about so many things. Now,
yes. The
one man who said you're obsessed with African attire. Someone is obsessed with African. I like African attire.
Though. Yes.
I do it a lot. But
yeah.
Somebody is being obsessed with
African. Yeah. You know,
if you have an event, especially to put on suits,
yes.
You know, they say dress corporate.
Mm.
Can you go with an African attire?
Who would be expecting me to dress in suits?
But you know, it's generally accepted in our society.
Who is the generally?
Well, you know what we are talking about now.
It's just.
They will ask you dress official.
Dress official.
And when they ask you dress official,
yes.
You know what they meant.
So when they say official, what might be official to you? Who be official to me? But in any case, let us take a look at the societal view and all of those that you have to wear suit and all of that and all that and all that. But I still wear what I have to wear.
And that's
yes, and I'm accepted. Yes, you see, that stands me out in any place that I go to. Whether it is Washington, whether it is China, whether it is Ghana, it stands me out. I can't lie to you. And I'm very, very proud of it. You know, it does not remove from who you are. You get what I'm saying? Those the suits, for me, they are cultural kind of dresses that matches the environment where they came from. So we are in a temperate region. Why should you ask me to wear suit in a very hot region, sweating, maybe with a white shirt in it? You
it's
know,
funny.
It's funny.
Yeah.
But there are exceptional cases, like when I have to go to classes at the LBS and all that, then I have to wear suits. You know, but in any but now they have even relaxed it that you can even wear your traditional attire, but it has to be complete with the cap, with everything. So you are allowed into the classes and participate and all that. So, but for me, the African attire depicts who we are.
Exactly.
So we are saying we are in a knowledge environment, we are in a global world, right? If the Chinese are active participants and dominating the global world, we have the Indians also dominating the cyberspace. What are they taking to the cyberspace? They are taking their culture, their tradition, to make them unique in cyberspace. So if you are creating an innovation that will sell, that will make money, that will become profitable, you have to create an innovation based on the uniqueness from your environment. So if you try to emulate the Western environment and you create innovation that is based on their environment, for God's sake, you can never be an just Jay-Z in Nigeria. You can't beat Jay-Z to it. You have to be a Nigerian Jay-Z. And to be a Nigerian Jay-Z, you have to add Yoruba, Igbo, and the rest of it to make it different.
Work, yeah.
Exactly.
Bayero Agbebi Foundation.
Yes.
Tell us a little about it.
What is it all about? It's actually a center where we talked about cyber responsibilities. We see a lot of youth today because Nigeria today has about 115 million smartphones. That means that 150 million Nigerians have access or has access to the internet. But those 115 million Nigerians, what are they doing with the internet?
Exactly.
Okay. And then again, it has posed a serious challenge for upbringing, for you training your children in Nigeria. For instance, your child can come back from school today and he will just say, "Hi, daddy, hi, mommy." You say, "Welcome from school," and he goes into his or her room, pick up the phone, and then chatting with a friend in the US who may be a drug addict, and your child may not know, and you two may not know. And you think your child is within your confines.
It's a great change in his life.
Exactly, and all of those things. So what that foundation does is to get, you know, the youth together, give them the relevant skills at no cost. We get corporate bodies and other institutions to support us, to train them in the way that they will use the internet for the right reasons.
The positive reasons.
Yes.
How do they get to this foundation for the youth who are interested? How do they get?
So all they need to do is, they can just log on to our website, tmclonline.com, or they can even Google my name. It's so easy. tmclonline.com.ng. Just Google my name, Bayero Agbebi.
And they'll get to the...
You will see everything. And then you just send me a mail. You'll be trained free.
And nothing is expected of you.
Nothing is expected of you.
Wow, it's okay. It's been wonderful speaking with you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very
much.
Thank you so much for coming. My guest has been Dr. Bayero Agbebi. And he has said it all. He said our work is on our brain. Over the weekend, we took a trip to Eco Hotel and Suites. It was Apororo versus Apororo. Enjoy the show. It was thrilling.
I don't drink alcohol. I will drink them again now. Who supports again? Give me a break, make a go once and for all. Okay, peace. The father will carry for a concept of drink. Cross for that one, so better than that. So if when doesn't finish this one, sponsor me now. They'll just pay 5 liters, say, young man, drink up, we pay for them.
Do you wish to meet your role model, mentor, or celebrity? Send your name and the name of the person you wish to meet to the number on the screen or to our email. BD's Wells, changing your mindset.
Apororo is a man to watch. Wow, it's been a wonderful Shakespeare. I just said that I actually want to knowledge and running a business. And he said it, there's a lot of schools that can teach you how to run a business. So look out for one and train yourself on how to run a business. Having a passion is not enough to run a business. That's what you'll be taking today on BD's Watch Show. Remember to keep it ready with us. Same station, same time, next week. Bye.